can start off being a basic hand bender. The thing with rotary draw bending is that every radius, every diameter requires new dies. You need a new wiper die, you need a new bender die, and new clamp dies. So if you're going to do this kind of work, it's usually for production run quantities. What it does do is it bends nice tight diameters. One of the problems with it is with the nice tight diameters is what do you do with the compressed material or the elongations. And this kind of work is, you can see that there's a groove there because they're not able to deal with the material. So this is a picture of a complex bend on a rotary draw bender. So this would have been bent at one end and then it would have flipped it around and bent it at the other end. Sequence is very important because it all has to be stuck down that straight mandrel. And if you do the wrong bend first, that's not going to work out. And this is an example of what happens when you elongate this outer radius, it thins out. And when you compress the inner one, it thickens up. So the thicker the material, the easier it is to bend. So a picture of stainless steel. This is a Cubes rotary draw bender, so the ones that are going today, you'll see that. And this is a picture of finished product for us. And what these are the barricades that go around supermarkets so that people don't steal their shopping carts.